Now we are having the data over here, the two column data, and I select it and I now want to plot it with a line symbol. So we are having the line as well as the symbol with it. Inside this menu we are having line series, 2 point segment and 3 point segment, so we can decide about them. In segments, in this we can do the same plot from here by selecting line symbol, and from here we can select the segments, the different patterns. Here we first go with this one, so it will be able to do the line plot. So I am doing this one from here, and now we are having the line plot. The very first thing over here that I will have to select the axis, so click here, and now inside this menu let me decide about my plot. So the very first one is the scale, and I select 360 here and I select 400 here and I apply. Now I want the vertical axis, the vertical axis from minus 2 to 80, and it is here. If I want to plot the lines there, so I will go to the grids and I will select the opposite here and the opposite here, and I apply, and they are here. Similarly, if I want to change the legend, now from the legend I double click here and I select that it should not have any box, so I select none, and now it is like this. Now inside this one, when I double click on this, then I will have the scatter menu here. So the scatter menu will have now a little bit changes with the scatter, because from here when I select, I can go back to line, I can go back to scatter, I can go back to column as well. But for the means from here, let's say I select only scatter and then apply, and this the line disappears, and I just want to discuss this one. So the line is there, though not very visible. So let me do some changes here and then the things will be visible. The very first one here is line. So line properties are here and then symbol properties are here. In the line, it is saying that connect line, no line, straight, 2 point segment, and so on, different option. Let's say I select the straight. Now the solid, the line should be solid, dash dot in various types here. Similarly, the width, let me increase the width of it to 3, and now it will become visible there. You see that now it is visible. From here I can also see this thing, that now it has some visibility. Let's say the line I make of different color, and now it has changed the line as well as the data point here. So now I go to this one, symbol, and now from the symbol I'm having the symbol like this. Let me change it to this symbol, for example, and now it is like this. I can change the edge thickness, so the edge will be very prominent over here. This is the edge, and the fill color is this one. So let me change the edge color to blank, and now we are having the black circles while the connecting point is a red line. And I can change the thickness. The default thickness it is taking is very thin, so I just change it to 30 and I apply, and now I am having those circles with more edge thickness. the fill color I can decide, let's say the fill color I decide is red. So now we are having the red filled circles, while the edge of it I want to make it more prominent, so it is like this. It is black, and then the connecting line is a red line, and we are having the plot like this. We can go to the drop lines, we can skip some points here, and if I skip 2 points, then the plot becomes like this. And I can press OK, and now our graph is there. This is our plot of the line plus scatter. So these two are here. Rest of the things that, like for example, these the tick levels here, the tick lines should be inside, and all this I have discussed in the earlier video, how to change this size, how to change these, how to change these one, how to insert here the values. So I will have to decide about the increment. If for example these seems congested, then I can change the increment here as well. And our data is actually ready here for a simple line plus scatter plot.